Hello and welcome to this video lecture on hidden section and expose station problem in wireless network. So for understanding this problem, first we will understand basic of this problem, that is CSMA protocol. What is CSMA? CSMA is a carrier sense multiple access protocol. So for understanding the working of this protocol, we will take two nodes. Let us take node A and node B, and these nodes are in the range of each other. That means B can communicate to A, and A is also in transmission range of B. Okay, so how they will communicate? So for example, say if A wants to send a data to B, then A will listen before transmitting to ensure the medium is idle. So A will check whether there is any data already getting transferred through the medium or not. So if it is not, then when the medium becomes idle, pick a random slot out of 32 possible slots and transmit the data. If the receiver does not acknowledge the packet, back off for the short random interval and retransmit. So whenever this medium is idle, A will send a data. Then it will check for the acknowledgement. So if acknowledgement is not received, then he will wait for a certain time, and then again it will try to send a data. So this is the simple protocol CSMA, carrier sense multiple access. That means it will sense this medium, wireless medium. It will sense, will check whether there is any other data is transmitting or not. If not transmitting, then it will only send the data. Now what problems can occur because of this? So problem occurs is the first problem that occurs is a hidden terminal problem. Now same is given diagram. A and B are in the range of each other. A and C are in the transmission range of each other, but B and C are not connected. B's transmission range is up to this. So C is outside the transmission range of B, and B is outside the transmission range of B. Okay, now for example, say B wants to send a data to A. Then what will happen? It will check this transmission medium, whether it is idle or not. So for example, say it is idle, so it will send a data to A. Now at the same time, if C also wants to send the data, it will only check a transmission medium, this. And if it is idle, it will also send a data at the same time. So A is receiving a data from B and data from C at the same time. So this is called as the collision of the data, happens because of the hidden terminal. So hidden terminal means B is hidden from C and C is hidden from B. So A can hear B and C. B and C can't hear each other. That means they are hidden from each other. They both interfere at A. So they, at the same time, they are allowed to send a data, but the collision will occur at A. So this collision occurrence is called as the hidden terminal problem. B is hidden terminal to C and vice versa. Carrier sent as sender is useless. So they like a hidden station problem, another problem is a expose station problem. Now consider this in a scenario that B is in range of A and A is in range of C. So B is connected to A as well as C. Now A and C are in the network of each other. C and D are in the range of each other. So ACD, BAC are in the range of each other. Now A transmits a data to B. So A is transmitting a data to B. Okay. Now C checks whether the transmission is taking place or not, because as it is transmitting the data B, that means it will transfer a data in the to the C also, because it is a wireless medium and A will just send a data without knowing the position of A. So the data will go in every direction, so it will go to C also. So A will check, C will check whether the transmission medium is free or not. So C is exposed to terminal A's transmission. So it will sense that A is transmitting a data to a B. So this sense is come to C. Now for example, say if C wants to send a data to D, so this medium is free. This medium is free, but still C knows that there is some transmission here in A. So it waits for this transmission take place, and then when this transmission completes, then only C sends a data to D. But here, as this link is available, or as this medium is free, C should send a data to D, but it is not done. So this problem is called as the expose station problem. The meaning of this is, even though medium is free, C doesn't send a data. That is called as the expose station problem. So C is exposed to A's carrier sense. That's why it prohibits itself to send a data to D. So these are the two problems that occurs because of the carrier sense. Now key points to remember here is no global view of collision, different receivers, here's the different senders because this is the wireless medium and they listen to each other. Collision happen at the receiver, many times collision happens at the receiver, goes up MAC protocol that we are about to study with the help of request to send and clear to send packet, or detect if receiver can hear the sender, tell senders who might interfere with the receiver to close his operation or to shut up. Okay, so we'll understand simple CSMA MAC, CSMA CA means carrier sense multiple access collision avoidance. This is collision avoidance algorithm. So how it was, maintain a waiting counter to C. For example, say C equals to 1. Then for each time channel is free, so it will decrement the counter, so C will become a 0. And when transmitter counter becomes a 0, that means a medium is idle, and at that time the data is sent over the channel. When a collision is incurred, then retransmit an exponential backup. So it will, if the collision occurs, then it will backup and will set the timer to a exponential time. Okay, so we will understand the working with the help of two messages, RTS and CTS. RTS stands for the request to send, and CTS stands for the clear to send. These are the two messages exchanged in order to avoid the collision. Now, how it works? The before every transmission, sender sends an RTS, that means request to send. So A, if wants to send a data to B, then it will first send the RTS. So RTS will, B will check whether there is another medium channel here which is already sending a data. If it is not, then it will send a message as clear to send. And if it is busy, or here some there is one channel and it is also sending the data, then it will not send this clear to send message. So it will wait for this transmission to complete and then only will send a clear to send. Contents length of the data, receiver sends clear to send, sender sends a data, receiver sends acknowledge after transmission. So this is the working. Okay, so we will understand working with the help of the diagram. So B wants to send a data to A. B wants to send a data to A, so it will first send RTS message, that is request to send. Then as the medium is idle, A will send a clear to send message. Now this clear to send message will be received by this as well as received by this. Then B will start sending the data, and as this C had received the CTS message, that means it will know that someone else in the range of A is already transmitting the data. So it will back up, so it will solve the hidden station problem. Even though B and C are the hidden from each other, because of CTS message that is sent from A, it will go to B as well as it will go to C. So C will come to know that B is already transmitting the data, so it will back up or it will shut up for a particular time. Then a data transfer will take place, and then the C will be allowed to send a data. So this solves the hidden station problem. Request to send and clear to send solves the hidden station problem, but still the problem remains because of the if request to send message is lost or clear to send message is lost, then also there is a problem of hidden station. So in some extent it solves the problem, but the problem is not completely solved, and exposed station problem still remains. And so drawbacks of RTS and CTS. So there is overhead of the smaller packets, that is the request to send and clear to send. So if data is very less, then also this is request to send and clear to send data packets are required to exchange. So it increases the overhead. Request to send still goes through CSMA and can be lost. CTS also can be lost and causes the collision. So this is about the hidden station problem and exposed station problem.